starting off tonight with Stone Angel Brewing's Highlander Wee Heavy Scottish Ale. They describe it as having a complex malt and caramel character. A satisfying beer for the cold winter months. Oh, oops. It's spring here. Oh well. So today I am doing a teardown of this photocell. It's a street lighting photocell. And I know that because I found it on the ground beside a street light pole. Slightly deformed, mashed with a little bit of, what is that? Looks like a little bit of cedar in there. Nice. Anyway, this particular one is made in the U.S. It is made for the North American market. It is rated between 105 and 305 volts, 50 or 60 hertz. So it could be used overseas, I suppose. It can switch 1,000 watts or 1,800 volt amps. And this particular one was manufactured in March of 2019. On the top of it, we have the manufacturer's name. We have instructions for remove and install. So this has a twist lock kind of a plug on the bottom of it. So to remove it, you turn it that way to pull it out. To install it, you crank it that way. And you install it with the window, the little translucent window facing north. Because that's where the photocell is in behind that little window. And other than that, there's nothing really notable on the outside of it. This particular one has been mashed. Not sure if that's what happened when it hit the ground coming down from the street lighting pole or if it was run over by something after it hit the ground. But regardless, it is slightly damaged, so that should make it a little bit easier to open up, you would think. At least you'd hope so, anyway. There we go. That was pretty easy. Whoa! That's huge. Okay. The hell is that? That big beast is in parallel with the line in neutral, so the hot in neutral. It is, I'm going to guess, an MOV. What else would it be? So our big round friend is in fact a metal oxide varistor, aka surge suppressor, surge absorber. It is this type, the 40mm D75, and it's a 481, which means it's a 480 VAC device, which makes sense because the maximum voltage that this thing is designed to deal with is 305 volts, so 480 is a good safe number. So that is these two connections here, line and neutral, to power this thing. And then this will be the load output coming from this little relay in here. The rest of it is just the circuitry to control that. Looking a little bit closer, there is the little photodiode. What does it say? Q1, phototransistor, that is looking out the window on the side of the case here. Just a slightly grayish, I think. Yeah, I think that's a grayish plastic. What else do we have on here? We have a capacitor, which is probably part of a capacitor dropper, I would guess. What is the value on that? 450 microfarad? I'm thinking that's what it is. Wonder if I can desolder this and get it out to reverse engineer that. That would be cool if I could. Other than that, there's a fairly powerful resistor there. I can't read the colors because I'm colorblind, don't you know? But we'll maybe measure that later. There are two diodes, so it's a half bridge rectifier. It's not a full bridge. Interesting. Other than that, there is a couple of other capacitors, a whole bunch of resistors, two other diodes that are not rectifier diodes, so have to maybe Zeners for the power supply. One of them probably is anyways. And then the rest of it is all just resistors. Oh, there's a third diode there. Yeah, that's not too much to the circuit. If I can get it desoldered off that board, I think I'm going to give it a shot at reverse engineering it. There. Wow, that was a bit of an effort. But this thing is working like a champ. I'm well pleased with that. On the back side of the board, nice generous tracks for the AC. There is the switched output. There is the input to the relay. It means these two will be the control inputs, I guess, of the relay. Looks like, oh, it was right, that is the series dropper capacitor in the power supply. Goes over to two diodes. I'm going to draw this thing all out, but I'm just doing a rough look around right now. And it looks pretty cool. The line and the switched line have fairly good separation around them, so that's nice to see. So before I take a bit of time and draw out this circuit, Big Clive did a teardown of a similar type of unit designed for the European market, or the UK market. This one clearly is designed for, with the North American market in mind, since it was made in North America, and it is a different circuit. The one that Clive found had a 555 as the main chip in it. This one has an LM2903. LM2903 low power dual voltage comparator, which makes sense. It is comparing the input from the light sensing device, which I think is an optotransistor, comparing that with a reference voltage and creating the output. So comparator is a perfect thing for that. That's what they do. They compare. But right now I'm going to go away, draw this thing out probably a couple of times to make it legible. Have a few sips off my beer and then I shall come back. So this is pretty much what we guessed earlier too. It doesn't really surprise me too much. There's a few details in here, but you know. First thing, this guy here is an MOV. It's a 480 volt MOV. Then the live goes through 150 ohm resistor, this big one there. And then through the capacitive dropper, 560 nanofarad with a 1 meg resistor in parallel with it. Again, right there, no surprises. Two rectifier diodes, these guys here. So the ground connects to the neutral, which also connects to the ground side of the rectifier. Then we have a smoothing capacitor. This guy, sorry, it's, which one is it? It's this one over here. Then a 125 ohm resistor and the 27 volt Zener diode, which is right in there beside that capacitor. And that is our 27 volt power supply that powers the whole thing. Flipping to the B side, we have the phototransistor, which as far as I can tell is an NPN. There aren't any part numbers on it, but the emitter and collector are marked on the board and the emitter goes to ground. So that's got to be an NPN internally. And of course the light just acts as the base. It's got a series resistor up into these various other resistors. There's a pull up to 27 volts. That'll go to the inverting input of the first comparator. The non-inverting input has a feedback resistor and it has its own voltage divider between 27 volts and ground. The output of that has a, what looks like a pull-up resistor, and then a resistor with a diode in series just to keep the current going in the correct direction, and then a much larger resistor going across it. What is R19? I didn't measure it, and I probably wouldn't be able to measure it in circuit anyway. That's not R19, that's R11, because I can't draw very well. Can you tell me what R11 is? I'm not sure. I certainly can't. Anyway, for the purpose of this discussion, it doesn't really matter that much. It's just taking part of the signal from the output of that first comparator, sending it to the inverting input of the second comparator. A little filtering capacitor here. Filtering, or is that a bit of time delay, maybe? Yeah, I think that one might be a bit of a time delay. Anyway, on the non-inverting input, it's the same arrangement. We have a voltage divider and a feedback resistor, which I forgot to label. Doesn't matter. Anyway, the output of that second comparator, just pin 7 on the chip for anyone that cares to play along, goes to the snubber diode and the coil of the relay. And the other side of that relay coil just goes to ground. And of course, the relay then just switches the line and load. That's all there is to it. And again, that shouldn't be super surprising. There's not a lot going on in here, but it is interesting to see that this is a different arrangement than the one that Big Clive tore apart a couple of years ago. I'll put a link to his video down in the description if you're interested in checking it out, because it's also pretty interesting. And I watched it before I watched this one just to see if there were any differences or similarities. And I mean, it's a little bit different because it's using a different chip for the comparator, but the one that Clive took apart was using a 555, and internally it has, among other things, a comparator and a voltage divider. So now, if you're wandering around town, take a look up on top of the street lights. It'll be right on top of it, and you will see something like this. I more commonly see ones that are light gray around here, but obviously they use these because I found one. It is an interesting thing to take apart nonetheless. So I hope you found that interesting. I had fun taking it apart. Questions and comments down below as usual. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.